And welcome, everyone, to the SSN Network. We're coming to you live from the Centre Sportif in Gatineau, Quebec. And we'd like to welcome you to the 2010 Norseca Junior Men's Volleyball Championships. This is the bronze medal match that's just about to get underway between Puerto Rico and Cuba. I'd like to take this time to introduce myself. My name is Doug Anton, and my partner at the desk here, my analyst for this evening, is Brenda Willis from Queen's University, head coach of the men's national team, or university team. Sorry about that. University of Queens. And down on the floor, we have our roving reporter, Kim Valliere. Welcome, Brenda.
Thanks, Doug. I'm happy to be here. This should be an exciting match. These two teams both having lost their semifinals last night. We'll see if they can be poised and bounce back. It's an important match for both teams, not just from a medal standpoint, but from a berth standpoint.
That's right. A berth is on the line to the World Championships next summer, is it not?
That's right. Next year in Brazil in the summer, the 21U World Championship will be held. And the winner of this bronze medal match will get the third berth out of the Norseca zone. Norseca stands for North, Central, and Caribbean Zone of the FIVB World Federation.
That's right. Now, really, both of these teams from yesterday, I think, from their perspective, would be coming off fairly disappointing losses. I think both teams have sort of suggested they subperformed, and so it really is going to be a question of whether they can rebound from that loss yesterday to come out with a better performance today.
Yes, before the match, I had a chance to talk with each of the coaches, and they both offered some insights. First, speaking with Roberto Garcia from Cuba, he was extremely disappointed yesterday and said that concentration in his group really broke down against the Canadians, and he was quite disappointed and felt that concentration will be a key to success tonight. He also felt that their tactics had to work together, and particularly in blocking and serving. He was disappointed last night and feels that if they serve well and put a disciplined block up, they have a good chance.
Right. And, of course, Puerto Rico lost to the United States yesterday, who appeared to be a very tight-knit and well-coordinated group. They seem to really play well together as a unit.
Yes, and the coach of Puerto Rico, Ramon Lawrence, said that efficiency was key for him, keeping unforced errors low and working hard. He was concerned that everyone bring energy and emotion, and his biggest thing is to establish his P1, or his left side pass and attack game, early on. He also mentioned blocking discipline, so I think both coaches are concerned about their blocking tonight.
Yeah, I think both teams needed to play better at the net yesterday, so I think that's certainly going to be a primary focus for both of these squads today, to get a little bit more presence at the net throughout the match.
In the first semifinal last night, when USA played Puerto Rico, they fell in three sets. The U.S. won 25-15, 25-23, and 25-16. The Cuba-Canada match appeared to be a little bit more of a battle initially, when Cuba won a close 25-22, but then Canada bounced back and won 25-19, a remarkable 25-7, and finished it off at 25-15 to win 3-1. So I think both teams are needing to rebound and put that behind them.
Yeah. So on some respects, this will be a character-building match for both teams. The teams that can come out now focused, will have the best opportunity to earn that coveted berth to the World Championships next summer.
They're just introducing the starting lineups of both teams. It's interesting to see the size of the liberos in these matches. It's really opened up the game for the small player. Looking at the huddle of Puerto Rico in front of me, the head of the libero is buried in the armpits of the other players.
Yeah, it does paint quite an interesting picture. But, he's been a real key player for the Puerto Ricans, so we can't use his stature as an indicator of the quality of player he is. He's really stabilized their passing game throughout this tournament.
Oh, for sure. Size doesn't matter in libero. If they have fast feet and read well, I think it's a real asset that it's opened up the game to players of all builds.
Absolutely. Well, both starting lineups have been announced to the venue. And we're just a few seconds now away from the opening serve.
looks like the Cubans may have a little bit of a size advantage over Puerto Rico. A little tough to tell. We're sitting two stories up, but it does appear that those are longer femurs.
Yeah, there's definitely a size advantage, and of course the Cubans are legendary for their athleticism. But Puerto Rico is also a very athletic team and can't be underestimated in that category as well. All right, ball has been thrown out to first server. Cuba is up to serve first in this opening set. To serve for Cuba is number 9, Izquierdo. And here we go. Pass by Arquila for Puerto Rico. And right away establishing the outside set to the back court.
Yeah, that's Christian Rivera coming out of the back row and hitting a C ball.
Great start for Puerto Rico. And we've got Perez back to serve. Jump float. Catches a net, handled by Cuba. And just out of bounds down the line.
Yeah, Treviso tried to paint the line and just missed. Ball brushed the antenna, consequently an error.
And it's Javier Perez back to serve again. And this time he's long, and quite a bit long. Missed that serve by 2-3 meters. Not really the type of serving they want right off the start of this match.
It was interesting last night. The Canadians opted to pass on the jump serve and went after float all night. And the Cubans struggled to pass it. So we'll see if Puerto Rico takes the same mentality.
And a nice solid kill off the block for number 2 for Puerto Rico, Jorge Lopez.
Yeah. Looked like he was a little early on that ball and had to hang and delay, maybe caught the blockers on their way down and was able to use the block to score.
Oh, just cleaning a little bit of water off the court. And looks like we're ready to go, and Jorge Lopez is back to serve for Puerto Rico. Poorly handled by Cuba. Out to big number 12, Fernandez Gomez for Cuba, but he gets blocked by a strong and tight Puerto Rican block.
Yeah, all three blockers up on that. Actually, I think Ricardo Arquila, the left side player, is the one who actually stuffed the ball.
Puerto Rico back to serve. And another long serve by, again, a good 3 meters long for Puerto Rico.
Really, the jump float is the serve of choice in this competition.
Chapleton back to serve for Cuba. And a little off-speed shot by number 12, Puerto Rico. And similar response out of Cuba. And a nice back row attack out of the middle of the court, up the pipe for Puerto Rico.
And Lopez come flying out of the back row. And it's interesting, it appears that the teams are trying to be a little more efficient and reduce their errors and consequently taking something off the ball. But at this level, if you're not aggressive, you're not likely to score.
Nice high dig by Puerto Rico. And a strong, sharp cross-court attack. It just tags the sideline. And that's a point for Puerto Rico.
Yeah, Ricardo Arquila with a sharp cross-court shot found his way inside.
Puerto Rico showing some fairly good defense early on here in this match. Back to serve. And another opportunity in the middle for Cuba. That was number 17, Jorge Gonzalez, killing the ball in the middle for Cuba. That's really, we saw two middle attacks in a row. Not something we saw a lot out of the Cuban team last night.
I think it's very important that these teams establish their middle early and get the opposing middle blocker tied up.
And Cuba tried to respond with a similar tactic, but gets stuffed by Cuba.
Yeah, Vergos went for a little bit of a slow quick there. The Cuban middle, to his credit, read that ball and was all over it.
Yeah, that was Jorge Gonzalez block, number 17. He's a very, very tall player for Cuba and gets up into the air and over the net very quick. Outside Torquilla. Nice dig by the Cuban libero, but can't quite handle it, and it goes out of bounds. A And now back to serve for Puerto Rico. It's number 12, Christian Rivera.
We'll see if they choose to float again.
No, it looks like he's coming with a spin serve. Easily handled by Cuba. Off the top of the block, kept in play by Puerto Rico. And flying out of the back row is number 12, Christian Rivera for Puerto Rico. Hits the ball solidly off the block, and it just trickles over top of the block and into the court uncontested.
Yes, I think at this point Puerto Rico is doing exactly what coach hoped they would do. They're establishing that outside ball, and as soon as the middle blocker starts to release early, they're coming back to the middle. So I think the setter for Puerto Rico so far has played a good chess game and getting a block that's not too set up.
And Cuba goes into the first technical timeout of the set with a lead of 4 points. Score is 8-4.
And, Doug, I think you pointed it out earlier, defense has been the key so far. There have been two good defensive opportunities by Cuba, and they got caught sitting back on their heels, ball dropping right in front of the digger twice, where Puerto Rico has capitalized on the transition opportunities.
Yeah, I think you're right. Cuba is still looking a little bit tentative, much as they were last night. They really don't seem to be comfortable yet in this match. Hopefully they're going to settle in, and we'll see a stronger performance as this match progresses.
Of course, both teams get two timeouts at their discretion, along with the technical timeouts.
Of which there are also two. All right, back to serve now after the timeout for Puerto Rico. Number 12, Christian Rivera. Again with the jump serve. A little bit difficultly handled by Cuba. The pass is slightly over, and the Puerto Rican block takes care of it and puts it to the floor.
Izquierda, the setter, tried to use the block and score on a dump, and the block was there. Able to stuff the ball.
Rivera back to serve again for Puerto Rico. Handled by Cuba. Good, strong cross-court attack by number 12.
Still didn't look comfortable for Gomez. I think expected the ball a little bit different location. Had to lean out to keep his hand on it. Good agility in the air.
And Gomez back to serve now. Strong attack. Handled by the Puerto Rican setter. Back row. Just hit about half speed. And Arquilla with the wipe-off shot off the Cuban block. Cubans are having a little trouble getting that block stabilized.
The Cubans don't appear confident on their swing. In warm-up, I thought they were hitting balls extremely authoritatively, and now they seem to be a little bit tentative.
Yeah, it's almost like they're playing a little bit afraid to lose, you know.
It's a good observation.
Arquilla to serve for Puerto Rico. Outside the left side. For Cuba. Great defense by the Puerto Ricans. And a nice scramble by Cuba as well. Free ball opportunity. Quick attack in the middle, and it scores for Puerto Rico. That's a beautiful transition.
And they're happy.
And that'll bring up Coach Garcia's first use of timeout in this first set for Cuba.
As they trail by a score of 5-11.
I think that was a wise timeout call. Cuba's in danger of being taken out of this set by the score. If they don't start to change the direction of things right now, they're going to be just playing to get ready for the second set.
Yes, and of course, with this rally scoring system, every serve is a point for one team or the other. The game is to 25, and you have to win by two. But clearly, when you get up 6 points, like they are right now, if all you do is trade side outs back and forth, and don't actually steal any real points, you can still win the set. So there needs to be some momentum change by Cuba. They need to string a couple together just to get back in this.
Ricardo Aquila to serve for Puerto Rico. Serves the ball deep. Poorly handled by the Cubans. Some net battles. And that ball is given to Puerto Rico. It's considered to be off of the Cuban blocker's last.
Yeah, a little jousting going on right on the top of the net. And head official Malcolm Mousseau from here in Ottawa area declare that that ball went off the Cuban block and out of bounds. So it's point for Puerto Rico.
Serve for Aquila again.
Really struggle with their hand serve receive.
Yeah, really struggling with the serve receive and poorly handled by the setter as well. That was number 15, Treviso for Cuba, just tipping the ball out of bounds.
I believe that was off the hand of the blocker, so Cuba has regained the ball.
Oh.
And
another strong attack by number 12 for Puerto Rico, Christian Rivera, out of the backcourt.
Yes, that weakness in the Cuban block was evident last night against Canada, too, and when the right side for Canada was able to score almost at will. Of course, he was left-handed. Now we're seeing a right-handed attack, but the block is just as ineffective.
Burgos serving for Puerto Rico. Backcourt attack, and a big, big block by Aquila for Puerto Rico on the Cuban back row attack.
Yeah, I believe that was Jorge Lopez, the left side, who helped and got a good piece of that ball. So a solid two-man block, and he couldn't hit around it.
In this situation in the past, Cubans have gone back to the same attacker very often. Let's see what happens. Nope, change up. Going to the big lefty in the middle, number 8. And to the outside. And a strong attack off the block by number 15, Lazaro Treviso for Cuba.
Appears Coach Roberto Garcia is not terribly happy. He is up there on the sideline shouting orders at his team.
Cuba with the serve. And powerful line attack from the outside by number 2, Jorge Lopez. Jorge Lopez has been one of the bright spots for Puerto Rico throughout this tournament.
He certainly has. Jorge Lopez sits third in the tournament so far with 56 attacks and 7 service points. He's actually got a total of 65 points for his team. That's the second highest Puerto Rican and the third highest in the tournament.
Cuba with a serve, Puerto Rico with a serve that just goes long. Cuba now back to serve. It's number 9, Escuerdo. And a powerful jump serve, which is overpassed, providing a free ball opportunity for Cuba. And an outside attack off the block by number 12, Zami Gomez, for Cuba.
That's a good, smart hit. High hit off the top of the hands. And I think Cuba's going to have to do that. They're going to have to serve more aggressively and really go after the block hard.
Treviso back to serve again. Another aggressive serve handled by Mulero. Kept alive by Cuba. Set to the backcourt. Mulero with the set. Free ball opportunity for Cuba. Let's see what they do with it. And Cuba scores. That's number 12, Gomez, with another attack off the block for the kill.
Interesting choice by Puerto Rico. He jumped, had a full approach, and Lopez chose to volley it over. And, of course, the libero was right there.
And Cuba is beginning to cut into the Puerto Rican lead here. And lose all momentum with a missed serve, kind of letting Puerto Rico off the hook.
Yes, but, you know, at this level, I don't think that's a bad error. He's earned 2 points for his team. He's being aggressive. I'd much rather see that in this situation than serving easy balls in, because the odds are fairly high you're going to eat the point anyway, because the other teams can run their offense.
Well, that's right. Certainly in the early going, we saw that, when Cuba was serving a little bit tentatively, there's making it very easy for the Puerto Ricans to side out. So really they've needed to try to put a little more pressure on Puerto Rico to give themselves a better opportunity to score some points.
Absolutely. I think the Cuban coach right now is telling his team, be aggressive, be assertive, make your presence known. We've got to serve aggressively. Don't worry about errors. If we put them out of system with our serve, we can get a big block up and slow them down. And that's our best chance of scoring points right now.
That's right. The score is 16-10 for Puerto Rico. We're just finishing up the second technical timeout. Recollection serves, it was 8-4 after the first timeout, so we've really been playing fairly even volleyball here for the last 12 or so plays. Puerto Rico back to serve. Number 2, Jorge Lopez. Handled by Cuba. Back to the outside attacker, number 12, Zami Gomez, who hits the ball out of bounds.
Yeah, the synchronization between the setter and the hitter seems to be a little bit off. That ball was fairly tight. It was 2 feet or so off the net, and the Gomez took off far enough away. They had to lean in to hit that ball, and his angle was too sharp.
Lopez with the serve again. The right side attacker, who also hits the ball out of bounds for Cuba.
Yeah, perhaps the old mentality of the harder you hit, the more luck you'll have. We have a substitution here for the Cubans. Entering the game for Cuba is Osoria, and leaving the game at the moment is Jorge Taylor.
Lopez back to serve again for Puerto Rico. Float serve handled by Cuba. And a wonderful dig by Puerto Rico, keeping that ball alive. Cuba with a second opportunity to score. And a big block by number 12, Christian Rivera, for Puerto Rico.
There again, it looked to me like Gomez was happy with the first set. He swung away on it, but great transition by Puerto Rico to return it. But on the second ball, it was tight and inside, and again, the adjustment on the ground wasn't good enough. He had to lean in the air. Block was right in front of him, and the result is a roof.
Yeah, certainly looks like the outside attackers for Cuba are approaching the ball to attack a little bit tentatively, which is always a sure sign that the set hitter synchronization is not really there.
I would say 90% of the balls this setter is setting are balls he's having to move away from the net to set to. The hand passing is not up to the level they need it to be to run a good fast 51 in the middle.
That's right. All right, that's Cuba's second time out. Just finishing up, the score is 19-10. Very solid lead for Puerto Rico at this point. Lopez to serve. Passed by Cuba, again at the 3-meter line, though.
Great block
saved
by
Gomez.
Ricans.
Over to the right side to big number 18, Osoria. Ball's kept alive by Puerto Rico.
That's the first unforced error we've seen from Puerto Rico in a while. In that case, Lopez just tried to catch the deep corner, right back corner to one, and went a little wide.
Really and truly an unnecessary error. He had no opportunity to really score with that ball. All he could do was return the ball to the Cubans and begin to play defense, and he really gave him a freebie with that one.
Okay, we have Arias coming in to serve, taking Chapotin. Good serve.
And another big kill by Christian Rivera, number 12 for Puerto Rico.
He seems to be hitting zones of the court that should be defended by the block. There's been several swings by Puerto Rico that are not where the defenders are positioned for Cuba.
Puerto Rico serving. Number 9, Ribas.
Away from the net again.
And back to Gomez, number 12 on the outside for Cuba. And another ball off the block and out of bounds. That's the third or fourth ball that we've seen him score on in a similar fashion. He's really taking advantage of that Puerto Rican block when he gets the opportunity.
Yes, and that's just impatience by the Puerto Rican middle blocker, turning and facing the hitter, trying to reach for the ball rather than pressing to six and staying disciplined.
Cuba with the serve outside to Arquila, and he scores. Solid. Looks like he went in between the Cuban block. Cuban block wasn't solid.
If you recall, at the beginning, both coaches identified discipline blocking as being a key to their success, and it rings true.
21-12 with Puerto Rico serving. And served just long by number 12, Rivera, for Puerto Rico.
Yeah, some tossing issues there. The ball a little bit behind his head. Another Cuban substitution coming into the game. We have Yosvani Hernandez, and he replaces number 12, Zami Gomez.
Hernandez is coming in to serve. Usually means they're looking for a little bit more aggressive server in this situation. They really need to do something to get back into this set. And he does go at the ball hard. Pass by Malero. Out to Arquila, who rolls the ball into the pot and scores with an off-speed shot into the middle of the court against the Cuban defense.
Yes, sometimes an off-speed shot, if it's strategically placed and disguised by the hitter, can be just as valuable. It's often tough to get athletes this age to recognize the point is the same size.
That's right. Arquila back to serve for Puerto Rico. 22-13. Float serve deep in court. Oh, surprising the Cuban passers. Number 12 for Cuba, Gomez, felt that ball was out and let it go, but it caught number 18 by surprise, Osoria, and he ended up having to play the ball unexpectedly.
Levan Osoria is actually born in 94. I imagine he's a member of their national youth team. The Cuban team actually has seven athletes born in 94. And, of course, most of the others are born in 91.
And a crafty little shot by number seven, Perez, for Puerto Rico. The Puerto Rican setter plays a second ball over the net in an aggressive manner and scores.
Unfortunately, he got called for being on the top of the net as he did that. He actually could have been called for two things. It could have been a held ball directing to the opponent's side on a pass, but in this case, official Musso called him for touching the top of the net, the only part of the net that's now illegal to touch.
Ball saved by Mulero. Strong serve. Free ball opportunity for Cuba. Sets outside to number 15.
And that's
Trevisio,
what they need to
do. And he puts the ball away.
Absolutely. Strong, tough serve. Put the Puerto Ricans in trouble. Got a transition opportunity and scored. Got a long way to go with that game plan, though. Down eight.
Jorge Gonzalez for Cuba back to serve. And he takes an aggressive swing, but it goes just a bit long.
They've got to keep doing that, though.
Well, they're down in the count, and it's really we're into the end game of the set now. One point from the set being over Puerto Rico, they really need to take some aggressive chances and hope it works out.
At least to gain some momentum for the next set at this point.
Back out of the backcourt for Cuba.
Foot violation there.
Yep.
And the
official
caught it.
Picked up by the official. That was number 12, Christian Rivera.
I got the eye. I saw it too. Yeah.
You definitely do, yep. Backcourt attacker touched the 3-meter line and was called for being over. Cuba with the serve. Catches the top of the net. Outside to number two, Lopez. Kept alive by Cuba. Lopez goes at it again and just kind of slides it through the block, slides it off the block for the point, and that's the end of the first set. Puerto Rico wins the first set, 25-16.
Yes, that's a much more dominant outcome than I would have predicted. I did think Puerto Rico would come out a little bit stronger than Cuba, but definitely a dominating first set. I believe we have Kim Valier down on the floor ready to...
Yep, Kim Valier is down on the floor. We'll hand the mic over to you, Kim. Who have you got for us?
I'm with Miriam and Kelsey, two of the 140 volunteers that worked here all throughout the week. They were on the Ontario team this summer, and they're also going to be playing for the University of Ottawa next year. So why did you decide to volunteer here?
Mostly we are in love for volleyball. It's so big that like we, any taste of it we can get, we'll try to get.
Yeah, we got asked to play to volunteer, and without a doubt, we said yes. Just to watch like different countries play, different caliber and the speed and stuff.
How did you like your experience this week? What was your job, first of all?
The first day we did balls, but we were mostly been bringing the flags in, and it's been super fun meeting the teams. We've been talking with some guys and getting to know them. It's fun.
Yeah, for sure. We're making friends, and we'll see.
As volleyball players, what are you going to remember about the tournament? Is there a team that grabbed your attention or a player besides those ones?
We're just going to take back the whole experience of watching Canada yesterday. It was very, like, for everyone, it's like, I wish, like, for me, it's like, I wish I was there. And just seeing them was really nice. And just the speed of play is awesome. It's very fast, big hits, fun to watch, big blocks, too. I've been looking at Libera's, I don't know why. Mostly they're passing in their intensity on the court. I find it amazing, so it's fun to watch.
Is it going to be your next goal? Be in a tournament, an international tournament like that?
We'd love to both make the national team, so try it someday, maybe.
For sure. If not, we might go play pro in Europe. We'd like that. That's a goal of ours, so we'll see.
Thank you, girls. Enjoy the rest of the tournament.
Thank you.
Back to you.
Thanks, Kim. Well, you know, at this point, Brenda, it just seems that Cuba is not playing confident volleyball.
Yes, I have to agree, but I think it is a new set, and at this point, They have nothing to lose. The assistant coaches are talking right now in the huddle about the choices to use forearms versus hands, because they're really having trouble hand passing the ball where they want it to go. A lot of balls passed out at the 3-meter line, and the consistency or location of the sets by this young Cuban setter is not exactly what you need at the international level. And it seems that the hitters are successful when he's accurate, which is, of course, pass-dependent. And so it's a spiral. You know, it can be upward or downward depending on the quality of the pass. And I think that's going to be key. If I was coaching that team right now, I'd be talking about serve-receive being your priority and stay aggressive. Serving and swinging, stay aggressive.
And, I mean, we have to give kudos, though, to where it's deserved, to the Puerto Ricans. They really played a fairly error-free set in the first one.
Absolutely, and I think if they maintain that style of play and Cuba doesn't change, then it's going to be a straightforward match. We'll see if that happens.
All right, we're just about ready to get underway in the second set here. Puerto Rico will serve first.
Doesn't appear to be significant lineup changes.
No, up to serve first for Puerto Rico will be Javier Perez.
Cuba's gone back to their starting group.
And serves down the line.
The hand pass problem again.
Yeah, mishandled a little bit, and Puerto Rico takes advantage of the opportunity. They throw up a triple block and get the stuff.
Unfortunately, having to play out of system and serve receive makes life a little bit difficult.
Perez to serve again. Handled a little bit better by the Cuban passer this time.
And a very aggressive arm swing on the right side.
That was number 15, Treviso.
Puerto Rico got caught on the net there. That was number 9, Rebus, getting caught, maybe penetrating a little too much and catching the tape.
Back to serve, Lázaro Treviso for Cuba. Strong serve. Kept alive, good defense by the Cuban defenders.
Fortunately,
with the free ball pass right on the money. Weak attack in the middle for Puerto Rico. Kept alive by Cuba. And a nice kill on the outside by Cuba.
Yes, Cuba was fortunate to earn that point, actually. The libero backed up and managed a second ball and put it where no one was expecting it, and they had to free ball it over. And usually at this level, if you put a free ball over, you don't get it back. But they did, and they were able to capitalize second time round.
That's certainly the objective. Number 15, Treviso, back to serve for Cuba again. Another aggressive jump serve. Passed well. And big shot down the line by number 2, Jorge Lopez for Puerto Rico.
I'm really happy to see Cuba swinging more aggressively from the service line. I think that'll make it a much more exciting game.
Lopez with the serve for Puerto Rico. And middle attack scores for Cuba. Haven't used a whole lot of middle attack, but they really haven't had the opportunity.
Yes, and that time the passers stayed back, used their forearms, and were able to create the situation they're hoping for.
Chapleton back to serve, number 8. And a great save by the Puerto Rican libero, Mulero, on that pass, resulting in another kill opportunity for Puerto Rico.
Yes, and Ricardo Arquila with a power swing out in position 4 cross court and scored for an important point, wanting to keep things tied up here at 3-3.
Puerto Rico with the serve. Pass by Cuba, again slightly off the net. Kept alive by Puerto Rico. Nice chase by the setter, Puerto Rican setter. And another off-speed shot, just similar to the one we saw in the first set out of Arquila, that scores again.
Yes, and I didn't think that was actually all that deceptive, at least from this angle. It looked right away like he was running off-speed, and not enough read by the Cuban defender.
Puerto Rico with the serve. Right side attack by Cuba, goes off the block and well out of bounds. That was number 6. Jorge Taylor scoring for Cuba.
Yes, Taylor using the hands. A much more authoritative swing than earlier on. I liked what I'm seeing now by the Cubans.
And Taylor with the serve. Passed by the Puerto Ricans. And a strong attack kept alive by the Cuban defense. Free ball opportunity. Ball passed by Malero. Again, back to the right side. And number 12, Tristan Rivera with the kill. This time he puts it away.
I'm very impressed with Christian Rivera. He's able to jump and hit on his way up, or at the top of his jump. He's able to hang and hit on his way down. He's shown us line and cross court. Very complete attacker for his age.
And it's Rivera back to serve. Once again, poorly handled by the Cuban passers. Kept alive by Mulero. And Arquila with a strong attack, saved by Cuba. And we're seeing a great defensive display at this point. Another opportunity for Cuba. And a wonderful kill in the middle by number 17, Jorge Gonzalez for Cuba.
Cuba is really starting to play with a little more composure. They're swinging more aggressively, looking for transition opportunities to run their fast middle. It's working for them.
Zami Gomez serving for Cuba. And the ball goes just long. Good identification by the Puerto Rican passers.
But the officials believe that it brushed his uniform and called touch on that ball. And it's a Cuban point. They lead 6-5.
Back to serve again. Number 12, Gomez. Strong attack handled by Aquila. And great ball out of the backcourt by number 2, Jorge Lopez for Puerto Rico.
I think the setter, Perez, is doing an excellent job for Puerto Rico of switching between first and tempo balls, overloading zones, and getting two hitters coming at one blocker.
Served by Arquila. And another middle attack attempt by Cuba that's kept alive by Puerto Rico. Rejection by Cuba. Little net battle that Puerto Rico wins.
Yes, Ramon Burgos did a great job there, the middle, of being all over the place, helping block on both antennas, transitioning in the middle. Very good job by that middle player.
We're seeing a little bit more scrappy Cuban team in this second set. They're really going tit for tat with the Puerto Ricans at this stage. Score 7-6 for Puerto Rico. Aquila back to serve for Puerto Rico. Fast up, back to number 15 with a strong kill down the line. Treviso puts that one away, uncontested.
Yes, much better job by the Cuban setter when the pass is on the money. He seems particularly comfortable about 5 feet off the net.
Jorge Gonzalez with the serve for Cuba. And puts that one long. Took a pretty aggressive swing at it, just couldn't find the court. And that leads us into our first technical timeout. The score is 8-7 for Puerto Rico in the second set.
Well, it is nice to see these teams trading side outs now. The Cuban coach is certainly animated. He's expecting more of this young Cuban team. As I mentioned, there's 794 year of birth athletes and 193 year of birth athlete on this roster. We could see these players for quite a few years to come in the Rosica zone.
Yes, he's a very passionate coach, and clearly he's trying to instill some of that passion in his players. Cuba does look quite a bit more comfortable this set. They seem to be working their way back into this match slowly. We'll have to see how this one plays out.
I just want to take a moment and thank the Government of Canada, the Provincial Government of Quebec, the Ville du Gatineau, and SSN, Streaming Sports Network, for their support in running this event.
Of course, these types of events are quite the production, and they just can't be effectively run without the support of great sponsors.
And just a reminder that this is a best 3 out of 5 sets, the first 4 sets to 25, and you have to win by 2. And the 5th set, should we go to 5, will beat a set to 15.
And we're ready to get underway here again.
Oh, just some time delay. The official from Trinidad and Tobago is that Hussein didn't like the way the two players exchanged. They have to exchange at the sideline and not at the end line.
Burgos back to serve for Puerto Rico. Pass by Cuba. And strong outside attack by number 15, Treviso, for Cuba.
Yeah, Lazaro Treviso went very high on that ball, almost looking over the top of the block. And they really do need to reach high and hit deep if they're going to take this set.
Cuba with the serve. Mishandled by Puerto Rico. But Puerto Rico ends up with the point.
It's a held ball or a lift called on that. It was a great effort by the Cubans, but not quite legal.
Javier Perez to serve. Pass by Gomez. Another outside attack kept alive by Cuban defense. And second swing at the ball, just a little bit long. That was Jorge Taylor just in the ball. A little bit long cross court.
Yeah, I like his aggression, actually, but on that ball it was awfully tight, and he tried to avoid the block, went inside just a little too sharp, and missed the sideline.
10-8 for Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico with the serve. Back set to number 15, Treviso. Kept alive by Puerto Rico. But not quite able to handle it and gain control of the ball. Just slightly out on the Cuban side.
Yeah, that's a great effort by Ricardo Arquila, but the momentum he had in his feet trying to get to the ball transferred into the ball and sent it in the same direction he was going, and unfortunately that was out of bounds.
Lazaro Treviso to serve for Cuba. Aggressive serve, but just again goes slightly long. Misses the back of the end, back of the court by about a meter.
And they're definitely serving more aggressively now. If they can just keep them in, then it'll help them quite a bit.
Jorge Antonio Lopez serving for Puerto Rico. Back outside to number 12, Gomez, who scores on that one off the block.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure why Puerto Rican Arquila didn't play that ball. I think in his mind it was just going out, not realizing it was going out off his own blocker.
Yeah, a little bit of a mental error there for Puerto Rico.
Oh, that's
and
3 out of 4 serves for Cuba. That's not going to do it for them.
It's really hard to get back into a set or really pull away from another team if you consistently miss your serves.
It's not so much the points that get chipped away. It's the momentum that you feel draining.
And solid middle attack by Cuba. That was Jorge Gonzalez putting the ball away.
Yes, that's a little bit of a pushed quick, we call that, when the setter pushes it away from himself a couple of feet and just catches the seam in the block, and Gonzalez was up early and fast and found the hole.
Cuba with the serve. Oh, and that ball is just long, so that's a third missed serve in a row, I believe.
Yeah, and 4 out of 5.
For the Cuban offense.
And I thought Puerto Rico was pretty lucky because it looked like a bit of a miscue between two guys who were both going and pulled back. And rather than it dropping, it went between them.
Well, you know what they say, you've got to be good to be lucky. With the serve, number 12, Rivera. And that ball is just out of court. Comes back into court outside the antenna.
But again, that error by Cuba relates back to the serve receive. Those second and third contacts were just trying to compensate for a poor pass.
And that error causes the Cuban coach to call a timeout. Score is 14-11 for Puerto Rico.
Yeah, it's Cuba down 11-14, and Cuba also lost the first set 16-25, or we could say it in the positive. Puerto Rico won the first set 25-16 and is leading 14-11 in this second in the best of five series. So Coach is trying to emit some emotion from his huddle, talking about the importance of this match, and everybody's got to come out fired up. Yep. So he talked to me about emotion at the beginning and energy, I think they need more than that. They need toss placement on their serve.
Yeah, I mean, really, the story to this point in this set has really been unforced errors on the Cuban side. I think that's really been the difference that we've seen.
Yeah, unforced errors both from the serving and attacking portions of the game, but also defense. Puerto Rico is out digging Cuba right now.
Rivera with a serve for Puerto Rico. Handled by Treviso. Off the top of the block. And just goes in behind by Zami Gomez for Cuba.
Yes, Ricardo Arquila needed to respond quicker from position 4 on that ball. The ball did go off the block, so the blockers did their job, but He hung back a little too long, and the ball dropped before he could get there.
And Gomez with the serve, and he tags the back line, and that's an ace for Gomez for Cuba.
And that's exactly the response the coach would be hoping for after that timeout, is to fire his guys up. And, you know, it's a one-point game now as Puerto Rico calls their first timeout, leading 14-13.
Score's gotten a little too close for comfort for the Puerto Rican coaches, and they've decided to talk to their boys.
We're coming to you from the Norseca Junior Men's Volleyball Championships here at the Centre Sportif in the Ville de Gatineau. The winner of this bronze medal game will go to the World Championships next summer in Brazil.
Yeah, and that's a great opportunity for any young player, most certainly. Something they all dream of is representing your country at a World Championship.
So, quick timeout. Discretionary timeouts by the coaches are only 30 seconds. It goes very quickly, and we're back at it.
All right, here we go. Cuba back to serve, number 12, Gomez. And a good serve. Long back set by the Puerto Rican setter that ends in a kill for number 12, Christian Rivera.
Xavier Perez did a very good job of going against his momentum there, against the flow. He was running forward to get that pass and fired it back and put it on the dime.
Arquila with the serve for Puerto Rico.
Out of system.
Oh, big attack by number six, Taylor, for Cuba. It's dug by the Puerto Ricans. But second attempt is just too much for Malero, the libero of Puerto Rico, to handle. And that's a point for Cuba.
But what great defense by Jose Malero. That was a rocket down the line, and he put that up like it was nothing.
He just really defends back there with absolutely no fear. He's a completely fearless defender. Cuba with the serve. Arquila handling the pass. Kept alive by Cuba. Oh, and a real miscue by number eight for Cuba. Alessandro Chapotin just can't keep that ball in court.
Yes, but I think the coach, Roberto Garcia, is telling Alejandro that that's not a bad thing to do. It's not a bad thing to do to catch the other team off guard every once in a while. It's just a little bit long. But don't get panicked over it. You know, we're in this game. Let's stay focused.
Yeah, we are seeing at this point some very exciting volleyball. We're seeing some very aggressive attacking combined with some very excellent defense. It's really going to come down, I think, to be a battle of wills between these two teams.
Two fairly evenly matched teams, for sure. Coming into these medal matches tonight, there were a series of matches. Martinique lost to St. Lucia for the right to go on into the Final Eight, so they were out. And then Honduras and Guatemala played. Guatemala defeated Honduras for the 7th and 8th position. Trinidad and Tobago defeated St. Lucia in the next match. And then the Dominican Republic defeated Mexico for 5th place. And here we are in the bronze medal game.
Okay, our second technical timeout is just coming to an end. Score is 16-14 for Puerto Rico. We're certainly at this point in the second set, seeing a much closer set than we did in the first. Puerto Rico handled the first set quite easily, but Cuba's putting up quite a fight in this second set. Puerto Rico with the serve. Good pass by Cuba. And right over top is number 15, Lázaro Treviso, on the outside.
That's extremely authoritative. Reasonably good pass, very well located set, and an undefended kill.
Right, attack got it on the outside by Puerto Rico, kept alive by Cuba. Oh, and a little off-speed shot that finds the court for Cuba in transition.
Good job by Jorge Taylor to take a good look at the block and change his swing, going after undefended zones of the court.
Squared will back to serve for Cuba. Little jump float. Oh, pass is a little tight by the Puerto Ricans. Their setter is unable to handle the ball, and it gets called for double contact.
Yeah, Xavier Perez, I think, could have let himself be in the net a little bit more on that rather than trying to manage the ball without the net, although it may have been high enough that he would have hit the tape. So actually responsibility for that goes to the passer who passed too tight.
Score is 17-16 now for Cuba. And really, I think, Brenda, this may be the first Cuban lead in the entire match to this point.
I think it definitely is the first lead, and it's really come down to two things. They're passing the ball a little bit better, so the setter is able to distribute the ball more. But more importantly, they're being aggressive, both serving, and it's working, serving and then hitting outside. They've really made a difference between hitting out and hitting in, serving out and serving in. It isn't rocket science.
No, it's pretty simple, and they seem to be playing with more and more confidence as every point progresses through this match, and that can only help them down the stretch if it continues. Cuba to serve. Pass by number two, Lopez. Oh, and just the Cuban defender stretched out but just can't quite handle that ball.
I think the libero for Cuba had that ball lined up perfectly, and then it deflected on a reaching blocker, and it just bounced out of his direction or out of his range, and then he couldn't manage
Javier
it.
Javier Perez with the serve. Handled by number 12, Treviso. Excuse me, Gomez. And that ball put away by Cuba.
Cuba on the backside is extremely effective right now. I don't have stats in front of me, but I'd be inclined to say they're about 85% efficient from the right side.
I think you're right. Really consistent putting the ball away at this point. Oh, and a big, big serve by number 15, Treviso. Leads to an ace for his team.
That's the first time that they've broken out by 2 points, leading 19-17 in this second set.
Yep.
Aggressive really serving.
Really have Peru back on, or pardon me, Puerto Rico back on their heels at this moment. Treviso with the serve. And another strong serve that catches the end line for another ace for Cuba.
That's those points you hope to steal. As a coach, if your team comes out and they're not serving all that well at the beginning, you have two choices. You can ask them to back off and put the ball in, or you can say, be patient with each other. Keep serving aggressively, and then you pray that come 20 or 18, that those are going in instead of out.
Big serve handled by Malero on that time. And a nice solid kill off the block by number 12, Christian Rivera, for Puerto Rico.
Yes, I think the Cuban block needs to be a little bit more patient. They're a little early on the Puerto Rican hitters right now.
Puerto Rico with the serve. Oh, mishandled by a Cuban passer. Kept alive by Puerto Rico. And Arquilla with the ball off the top of the block, kind of finds a way through the block and puts it to the floor for a point.
That's 2 points on block errors for Puerto Rico.
Score is 19-20 for Cuba, with Puerto Rico serving. Rivera with the serve. And big, big kill off the block by Zami Gomez for Cuba. We're certainly seeing the Cubans at this moment playing with a whole lot more passion than we did in the early going of this match, aren't we, Brenda?
We certainly are. We now have a serving substitution. Once again, Yosvani Hernandez is coming into the game, and he's going to serve for Alejandro Chapotin.
And last time this substitution was made, Hernandez served the ball quite well for Cuba and got him a couple points, if I recall.
Serve and defense specialists are hard to find. It's a very difficult job to come off the bench having not been engaged in the play and be aggressive, serve and defend, and actually help your team at critical points like 21-19.
Yeah, you seem to have to be fairly immune to pressure. And this time it doesn't work for Cuba as Hernandez misses the ball long. And now we see a substitution for Puerto Rico. Similar strategy. Number 14 is coming in. Carlos Acosta is replacing number 9, Jose Ribas, with the serve.
Yes, and this is interesting because this athlete is born in 93. They're bringing a youngster in to do this pressure situation.
Serves easily handled by Cuba. Set up the middle. Number 17, Jorge Gonzalez, with the kill.
And that's what happens when you serve an easy ball.
You know, Gonzalez has been very effective attacking up the middle. Really, we haven't seen Puerto Rico handle his attack very well. Cuba just hasn't had as many opportunities probably as they would like to get him the ball. Cuba with the serve. Pass by number 2, Lopez. Weak attack by Aquila. But a big, big block by the number three middle blocker for Puerto Rico, Ramon Burgos.
Yes, Burgos really saved Puerto Rico there because Ricardo Arquila gave an absolutely simple free ball over the net. They're bringing in a bigger block. This is a great strategy by the Puerto Rican coach. Ramon Lawrence is bringing in one of his middle blockers to block in place of the setter. So they're going to run this transition play with no setter on the floor.
We'll see how it works out. Oh, and the serve is just a little bit wide.
Well, Emmanuel Romero came in and went out, a flawless game statistically, although no rallies to participate in.
That's right. Scores 23-21 for Cuba. Cuba also has a serve. Number 12 serving for Cuba, Gomez.
Oh, that was long.
And Arquila with a big, big swing, but he gets blocked by the Cubans. That ball looked like it was set just a little bit tight, Brenda.
Yes, absolutely a little bit tight. And the setter is talking to his team about that. Give me a higher pass and I'll give you a better set.
Yeah, Arquila really had nowhere to go with that attack except at the Cuban block.
And Ramon Lawrence is not happy with his setter right now.
Zami Gomez serving for Cuba for the set. And he puts it a little bit long.
He didn't go after it as hard as he can either. It's interesting. Maybe an 80% or 75% and still out. So that's a bit problematic.
Ricardo Arquila back to serve for Puerto Rico. Float serve cross court. And back to number 17 in the middle. A little tip over top of the block by Gonzalez to score and end the set.
And that was Jonathan Rivera with that tip to score. He's a 93 year of birth, so another youngster. Interesting, the number of youngsters that are seeing court time right now.
Of course, well, there's a lot of them on their roster, isn't there, Brenda? So
there certainly is. The year of birth is 1991, actually. That's the maximum age they can be. They have to be under 20 in this competition. We're looking for Kim Vallier. Are you there?
Hi, Kim. So it looks like you're there with Julien Boucher from Volleyball Canada.
Yeah, Julien Boucher is the High Performance Director. For those who are not really familiar with the structure of Volleyball Canada, what's your job exactly?
My job is, my title is High Performance Director. I kind of supervise all our national team programs from the senior level to the younger age levels. And I also act as a liaison between Volleyball Canada and all the our provincial associations and their elite programs, their provincial team programs.
So you're really working for the development of volleyball in Canada too?
That's correct.
All right, and how do you like the level of performance that we've seen here this week?
Well, this tournament has been... We don't host a lot of international events, so this is awesome for us. The tournament's been great. There's teams at different levels, obviously, because some of the Caribbean countries don't have the elite programs as developed as the biggest countries. But all in all, everybody's come here and has shown the overall level has been pretty good.
How do you like the performance from Canada?
Our team's been awesome. They've improved from match to match. Most of the teams in this tournament actually haven't been together very long. Our team's been together 2.5-3 weeks. So every time they get on the court and play, they get a little bit better. Last night was their best match of the tournament, obviously, and a great effort. And look for them to play even better tonight.
I asked Glenn Oak yesterday, how important was it for this team to make it to the Worlds for the development of the sports in Canada?
It is important in the sense that these guys have put in time this summer with their provincial team and then with our team. And, you know, the fact that we can be represented abroad in world championships, that's always a plus for us.
All right. Thank you, Julien. Back to you.
Thanks, Kim. All right. We're just about ready to get underway for the third set. We're tied 1-1 in set scores in this five-set match. Really seems the second set was a set that breathed some new life into the Cuban offense, Brenda.
Yes, it certainly was. In the first set, Puerto Rico came out storming 25-16. Cuba had a lot of trouble with serve receive and made a ridiculous number of serving and attacking errors. They stabilized themselves much better in the second set, put a lot more pressure on the Puerto Rican serve receive with rocketing jump serves, and subsequently went on to win 25-22. So we're tied up at 1-1. And here comes the first serve of the third set.
And it's Chapot in for Cuba serving. Passed by Aquila. An attack off the block down the line by number two, Jorge Lopez, for Puerto Rico for the point.
That is a very smart shot. He took a little bit off it, dropped his elbow, waited for the block to drop, and then tooled down the line.
And it's number seven, Javier Perez, back to serve for Puerto Rico. Passed by Hernandez. And long attack cross court by number 15, Lazaro Treviso, for Cuba out of the...
Yes, that right side attack again.
Yeah, well, he's really been, you know, for both sides, right side attack has been a very effective weapon throughout this entire match. Treviso back to serve for Cuba. And pass by number two, Jorge Lopez, for Puerto Rico is just a little bit tight. Their setter Perez cannot handle the ball.
Yes, and the call that Malcolm Mousseau is making at the moment is the call I mentioned that he had an option to use on a previous tight pass, basically turning and double-hitting the ball on a throw-over into the block. So he got nailed on that one.
Aggressive attack, aggressive serve down the line by Cuba, passed by Urquila.
Oh, net
attack
violation.
By Lopez.
Sorry, the second official missed the top of the net.
The line by Lopez. And ball out of the pipe. Back row, attacked by Urquila, off the top of the block and way out the sideline.
Yes, I guess that's sweet justice because, if I interrupted you, there was a point there where the Cuban block was all over the top of the net. Officials didn't see it, and they lost the point anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Lopez with the serve for Puerto Rico. Strong attack down the line by number six, Jorge Taylor, for Cuba. And the ball is off the block.
Yes, it's a good high hit. Hard ball to defend when it brushes off the top of the hands like that.
Number eight, Chapleton, back to serve for Cuba. Ball is passed by Malero, but it's a little too long. Gets on top of the net. And Perez, setter for Puerto Rico, can't handle it.
Yes, Perez is not that tall. He's 191 centimeters. And that's a pretty tough ball for him. He's reaching to the top of his reach just to touch that ball.
Chapleton serving again for Cuba. Handled by Urquila. And back to the back court to number 12, Christian Rivera, for the kill.
Rivera is only 17 years old. It's a pretty overwhelming talent.
Scores 4-3 for Cuba with Puerto Rico serving. Oh, and a little bit of a miscue there between the setter and middle attacker for Cuba, but he reaches high and just tips the ball over the block and scores. Jorge Taylor serving for Cuba. And strong serve at Urquila. Unable, setter can't handle it. It's played by another player. Kept alive by Cuba. And big, big block by Urquila from Puerto Rico on number 15, Lazaro Treviso, for Cuba.
Yes, Ricardo Urquila put a roof on that ball.
Yeah.
Solid penetration, both hands to the floor almost faster than it was hit.
Yep, straight down. Serving from Puerto Rico is number 12, Christian Rivera. Passed by Cuba. And that's a kill off the Puerto Rican defender by number 12, Gomez, for Cuba. That ball looked like it might have been going out. It might have maybe just touched the top of the block, though.
That's what I think Jorge Lopez thought, was there was contact, but the blockers came out and said, what are you doing? So we didn't touch it.
Serve for Cuba. Oh, mishandled by Urquila, but kept alive by great work by the libero Molero. Ah, but a great kill. To position one by Jorge Gonzalez, number 17, out of the middle for Cuba.
It's a good job by the setter to isolate that one-on-one in the middle. hasn't had a ton of opportunities to do that, but when he is doing it, it's very effective.
Serve for Cuba. And that ball is left and lands just slightly long. Nice communication between the Puerto Rican passers to let that one go.
Coach is acknowledging, that's a good swing. Don't stop swinging. I like that.
Ricardo Arquila to serve for Puerto Rico. Handled by Hernandez for Cuba. And out of the backcourt is number six, Jorge Taylor for Cuba with a kill off the block.
Yeah, that was a tough block. Jorge Lopez, I think, for Puerto Rico had it lined up very well. And unfortunately, the middle blocker couldn't quite close and it busted through the seam.
And we're into the first technical timeout of the third set. The score is 8-5 for Cuba.
This is the third set of the best of five match. We're tied up one each. Puerto Rico won the first set 25-16, and then Cuba bounced back and won the second 25-22.
Yeah, we're starting to see a much more passionate Cuban team has really started to appear early in this third set. Seen a much more confident play out of most of their attackers. Seems their setter has stabilized some of his location, of his sets, and the hitters have a little bit more confidence with what they're receiving as a set now.
Yes, yeah. At this level, so much of the game comes down to serve-receive, and that's you can just see the Puerto Rican coach is talking to them about their platform, about managing the pace of the Cuban serves. That's been the biggest difference is Cuba's going after their serves now. They're putting pressure on Puerto Rico's serve-receive, and they're not able to run in system nearly as much as they could early. It appears that Cuba's going to live and die by their jump serve.
Yeah, and it's working for them at this time. Okay, we're back ready to go. Jorge Gonzalez serving for Cuba. Off the net, pass by Molero. Outside ball and a big block by number nine from Cuba is Guerdo. He gets right over top of the ball and the ball lands at the attacker's feet.
Yes, that point is based on a centimeter, I think. It doesn't get any closer than that. It's a pretty good swing by the Puerto Rican outside hitter, but unfortunately the block was sealed.
Yeah, that was Jorge Lopez who swung at that ball, but he really had no place to go with it.
Yeah, up until this point, the top scorer for Cuba has been Jorge Taylor. He's ranked third overall in his in the tournament for 4 points. And for Puerto Rico, the top scorer, without question, has been Jorge Lopez. So when things get tough, we'll see if they run at those two hitters more often than anyone else.
But Lopez has been a little flat in this match. We haven't really seen a lot of offensive production out of him so far. It's really been all number 12, Christian Rivera, out of the right side that really has been getting the job done for Puerto Rico to this stage. I think they really need Lopez to start showing some of the attacking prowess he showed earlier in this tournament if they want to get back into this match.
Yes, it seems, though, that the Puerto Rican team is running him mainly when they're out of system and not giving him many one-on-one opportunities. Almost all the good passes are going middle and back, or possibly pipe.
That's true. Served by Cuba. And that ball just wide. Point for Puerto Rico.
Yes, that's a good swing by Jorge Gonzalez for Cuba. Just a little bit out of bounds.
Burgos to serve for Puerto Rico. Handled easily by Cuba. And out of the backcourt, but big, big block by Puerto Rico on number six for Cuba, Jorge Taylor.
Yes. Or Antonio Lopez shut that down rather impressively.
Yeah, he really came strong into the backcourt. Seemed to contact that ball just a little bit low and right at the Puerto Rican block. Outside ball to number 15.
Right at the
for
block
Cuba
again.
Treviso.
At the block again, but Rebus couldn't press. He caught his hands flat.
This time it goes out of bounds, giving the ball back to Cuba. Cuba with the serve. Arquila with the pass. Struggles a bit. Saved by Perez. Outside. That's a kill by number two, Jorge Lopez for Puerto Rico.
I thought the setter managed that second ball a little bit better. Perez tooled the block, and it was going out of bounds, but his teammate covered him so well that the play stayed alive, even though it would have been a point if he'd let it go.
Yeah, I think so. Perez serving. Back set by Cuba. And a big block by Puerto Rico. That was Jose Ribas with the big block for Puerto Rico.
Yes, we haven't seen a lot of things happening around Jose Ribas, but that, some key blocks at critical times. We're at 9-10. Cuba leading by one.
Perez serving again for Puerto Rico. And tight. Right back to the same player. And another big block by Ribas.
Yeah, I think
all of a sudden he's come alive in the middle blocking position for Puerto Rico.
We have to discredit the Cuban setter on that one. He put that ball right on the tape, and the block was all over it before the hitter could even touch it.
Yeah, truly the hitter didn't have a whole lot of area to go to.
No, at this level, because of the size of the players and how high they jump, if you set the ball right on the net, I often watch 17 and 18 U club teams play, and they set the ball right on the tape so their middle hitters can bounce the ball, and that simply doesn't work at the next level. The blockers are all over the ball before you even touch it.
It's truly a fight I have with my players at the college level, getting them to set that ball a little farther off the net to give our hitters an opportunity to avoid the block and work the block a little bit more aggressively.
Absolutely. And overall, this has come right down to fundamental tactics, serving, passing, and keeping the ball in play.
Yep. Well, off of a couple big blocks by Puerto Rican middle blockers, we've now got a tie game, 10-set, 10-10 in this third set. They've worked their way back into this set.
Yes, this could be a long match. And, of course, following this match, we're going to have the gold medal game between Canada and the USA.
Oh, scramble at the net. Puerto Rico called for a held ball. They're not too happy about it.
No,
fought hard to try to keep that ball alive.
Ramon Lawrence can't believe the call. Of course, up until this year, you couldn't go under the net and make contact with their territory. But now you can, provided you don't interfere. And he didn't really interfere. But he didn't get called for going under. He got called for a held ball.
That's right. And that's a miss serve by Cuba, keeping the score tied at 11-11. Puerto Rico back to serve. We've got Jorge Lopez.
Floating.
Serving a little bit of a short ball at the front row attacker. Number 12, Gomez. Mulero with the set. Up the pipe. Tipped over. Back out to Gomez. Who puts it into the net.
Yeah, but that wasn't hittable. Gomez didn't do a good job there simply because he should have recognized he needed to roll it. It was below the height of the net before it got to him. He needed to do something to put it up to get it over.
Jorge Antonio Lopez with the serve. Passed by Hernandez. Up the middle to the lefty. Ball's kept alive. Free ball opportunity. And great attack out of the middle. One of the rare middle attacks that we've seen out of Puerto Rico. That was number 9, Jorge Ribas, who all of a sudden has come alive in this third set.
Yes, good job again. Every time the transition opportunity is sufficient to run middle, Puerto Rico's done it and they've capitalized. Cuba's going to have to start committing in those situations.
And Cuba made a player change. Into the match came number 5, Quintana. The off-speed ball juggled but saved by Cuba. Out of the backcourt, strong attack by number 15, Lazaro Treviso, out of the backcourt. And it's out of bounds. Puerto Rico is arguing that it touched Treviso on the way out. And the lines official agrees, and the ball goes to Puerto Rico.
That's the right call. Cuba doesn't like it, but it's the right call. And we're at 14-11 Puerto Rico. They're breaking away.
Jorge Antonio Lopez back serving again. Oh, and badly handled by number 5, Quintana, for Cuba. Mulero with the pass. Perez with a set up the pipe. Saved. Weak dig by Cuba. And a sharp cross-court attack that cannot find the sideline by number 6, Jorge Carlos Taylor. And he's showing a little bit of his frustration right now.
As is the coach. He calls timeout and he wants to talk this over. He's not happy at all. His body language is pissed off.
Well, they went from a period where they had a 2-3 point lead in this set to now being down 4-15-11 to a rejuvenated Puerto Rican team that has fought its way back into the set.
Yes, I give Puerto Rico a lot of credit. They've been patient and disciplined. They're playing together very well. And I think Cuba has to go back again to what they were doing. They were serving aggressively, and they were going after the transition opportunities, and they've become a little bit timid again.
I totally agree. I think Cuba, first and foremost, is a power team, and they need to be displaying that power in more phases of the game. All right, we're just ending, just coming back from Cuba's timeout. Once again, it'll be number two, Jorge Antonio Lopez, serving for Puerto Rico. Passed by Hernandez. Out to big number 12, who gets blocked. Number 12, Gomez, gets blocked by Puerto Rico.
Once again, it looked like Gomez had the ball much too far in front of himself and having to lean with nowhere to go. So now we have Puerto Rico up 16-11 at the second technical timeout. And with a five-point spread, if Cuba doesn't start doing some things to steal real points back, they're not going to be in this third set.
Yeah, it's really been a change. You know, one of the things we always talk about, of course, as you know, in volleyball, Brenda, is really trying to avoid runs of points. Runs of points tend to be match killers for most teams, and that's exactly what Cuba has run into here. They've given up multiple points in a row, and that's really changed the complexion of this set.
Yes, and it appears that leadership on the floor is one of the issues. From my perspective, it looks like when things start to get tough, the Cubans walk away from each other rather than pulling together. And, I start to see some gestures with hands up and, maybe people being upset with each other rather than taking responsibility and owning their own performance. So I like some of the body language things I'm seeing from 15, Lazaro Treviso, because he's trying to pull them together right now.
Right. And, a great example of leadership is really coming out of the Puerto Rican side. Their libero, number 15, Mulero, is really doing a good job to make sure that everyone stays involved in the match. Ah, great kill out of the middle. Number 5, Quintana, really trying to motivate the Cuban side now and get something going.
Yeah, that was a great quick in the middle. Caught the Puerto Rican block on its way up, not quite sealed, and found the open court.
And Quintana back to serve. Pass by Mularo. Back set to Perez. To Christian Rivera. And he just mishandles that one.
Yeah, he was trying for the outside arm, and I think the outside arm pressed to the inside, and it was gone, and there was nothing to hit, so he hit wide.
Yeah, he may have been going for a little bit too much on that ball based on the position he had.
So we're at 13-16. Cuba's stolen one back. We'll see if they can get another.
Danger Quintana to serve. Bump set by Perez. And a big, big block by the Cuban side. Triple block put up in front of Arquila. And he can't find a way through.
Sorry, it didn't look like Ricardo Arquila got a big enough approach on that one.
That was a scramble, really, from the first contact on that play. Cuba with the serve. Oh, catches the net. Free ball for Cuba. Going to the middle, dug by Puerto Rico. Back set to number 12, Christian Rivera, who puts the ball away through the Cuban block. And Brenda, we've just seen, that Cuban block just doesn't seem that tight. There seems to be, Puerto Rico seems to be finding a lot of attacks and finding a way through that Cuban block.
It's hard to tell from this angle whether it's because setters are readable or not, but Puerto Rican block seems to be able to tell where to go sooner. The Cubans are chasing a little bit more and aren't sealed.
And we saw some communication error on that pass between number 12, Gomez, and number 15, Treviso. Oh, little ball off the top of the net, kept alive. Oh, and a big, big miss by number 6, Jorge Taylor, for Cuba, and their frustration is beginning to show.
Yes, Escuerdo is really frustrated with his hitters right now. I thought he did the right thing by moving away from the left side player. The matchup on the left side hasn't been working for him, so he spread things out, went to the right side to his captain, and that didn't work either.
Ribas with the serve, passed by Gomez and hit by Gomez, kept alive by the Puerto Ricans.
Oh.
And ball put into the deep corner, but it's just out of court.
Yeah, somebody moved that sideline on Lopez, because that was a great choice. It just missed.
Yeah, just couldn't quite find that sideline like he intended. Cuba back to serve. 15-19, third set. And that serve is long for Cuba, making the score 20-15 for Puerto Rico. And Cuba going to their bench, taking out number 6, Jorge Taylor, who's been showing a little bit of frustration and bringing in number 14, Hernandez.
We'll see if this change helps bounce them back. They're down 20-15 at the moment, and it's slipping away.
Rivera with the serve for Puerto Rico. A little bit of an easy serve handled by Hernandez. Outside to Gomez, who puts that ball to the floor with a solid kill around the Puerto Rican block.
Yeah, Escuerdo is lucky because there was some mishandling of that second ball when he set that ball, and it could easily have been called. But I think head official Malcolm Musso is inclined to let these guys play.
Gomez with the serve for Cuba.
Well handled.
Well handled, and big block by number 17, Jorge Gonzalez for Cuba. Really seemed to read that set to the middle all the way.
Yes, and although Ramon Burgos is upset with himself, I think in fairness to Burgos, that ball was set too low.
Gomez with a serve again for Cuba. Handled again by number 2, Lopez. Right side attack. A little bit off the top of the net by Christian Rivera, but it does find the court.
Yes, and in that case, we had Yosvani Hernandez sitting back on his heels to dig that ball, the substitute that just recently came in. If he'd been pushing forward even a little bit, he would have had that dig.
And Romero comes into the game for Perez, giving Puerto Rico a bigger block up front. Ball set outside to Treviso. Hits the ball. Strong cross court, and it's too much pace for Jose Mulero, Puerto Rico's libero, to handle. Score is 18-21 for Cuba, or pardon me, for Puerto Rico, but with Cuba serving.
And Romero is back out of the game now. The setter's back in.
Aggressive serve by Cuba. Little miscue in the middle. Tip for an attack. And the ball is out of bounds. No touch by nobody.
But that was a smart choice of shot, not well executed, but I think all he was trying to do is pop it off hands, and that was the right thing to do on that set. Unfortunately, the hands weren't as high as he was.
And we've got another substitution for Puerto Rico coming into the game to serve is number 14, Carlos Acosta, replacing number 3, Ramon Burgos. Out to Treviso. Oh, and a big block by number 7, Perez, for Puerto Rico.
Anytime your setter gets a block like that, you got to be happy as a coach. He put that right back in the power hitter's face.
He absolutely did, and he was quite happy about it. He really celebrated with his team on that one. Acosta serving again for Puerto Rico. Pass by Cuba. Back set. Kept alive by Arquila. Back, and big block by number 5, Quintana, for Cuba.
Oh. Yeah, that's a technical error by the Cuban blocker. When you go all the way to the top of your jump before you penetrate, you're extremely vulnerable to get tooled exactly the way he did. He needs to penetrate the minute his fingers are above the tape, all in one action, instead of going up and then trying to penetrate afterwards as a second action.
Back out of the pipe by Arquila. Out of the back row for Puerto Rico. And that ball is out of bounds. Puerto Rico thinks there was touch on the ball and is arguing. And they do get the touch call. And that is set point. Final score is 25-18 for Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico wins the third set and goes up in this match 2-1.
Well, Doug, I think that as we move forward, we're going to see one of two Cubas come out. If you recall last night against Canada, after Cuba lost a set like this, a similar score actually, I think was 25-17 or 18 last night. It was actually 25-19 to be exact, and this one was 25-18. Cuba simply fell apart, lost the next set. Extremely decisively 25-7 to Canada. And we could see that again if they come out angry with each other and they don't play with determination. Or we could see them bounce back like they did after the first set tonight and play aggressively and confidently and come back and win.
You're absolutely right. It really is gut check time for Cuba, and they really came off the court quite dejected. And really need to find some way to get their spirits up and get motivated and really get focused on getting back into this match. If you were their coach Garcia, what would be your advice to the Cuban players at this point, Brenda?
Well, I think there's a couple of things. I think they need to communicate a little bit more when they're blocking. Wait, go, and just remind them to each take their own piece and not try to reach for each other's, to work together a little bit more disciplined. The second thing is I would tell them to put a higher level of concentration into their toss when they're serving. If their toss is there, they should be going after it, because every time they do, it puts Puerto Rican offense in trouble. Puerto Rico has a good setter. He's distributing the ball well. He's pretty accurate when he's not running around. And their best chance of success on defense is to make the setter set from out by the 3-meter line. So those would be my two things. Be more patient, more disciplined blocking, and focus on your toss when you're serving. And let's make sure we get a good hittable toss and then swing at it hard.
Good piece of advice. I think we really have seen that Cuban defense has only had success when it's been on the back of a fairly aggressive first contact, which is the serve. And that seems to have been the key to setting up additional opportunities to transition for the Cuban offense.
Yes, and, you know, I think the majority of pressure here is on Cuba, not just because they're down 2-1, but because Cuba is a world power in volleyball, and to not qualify for the World Championships will be devastating for this team. Where for Puerto Rico, it's exciting. The prospect of going has to be exciting for them. Historically, they haven't been at the same level as Cuba internationally, and here they are up 2-1. So I don't think complacency will be a factor. Being comfortable at 2-1, it could be. Certainly urgency will be a factor for Cuba, because it's now or never. So we'll see which emotion and I think we'll know this fairly early when we see how Cuba comes out.
Yeah, and, you know, Puerto Rico needs to be careful here, too. They need to make sure they don't protect their one-set lead here and continue to play for the win in this match.
Yes, if I was the Puerto Rican coach, I would be reminding them, run middle in transition when you can. It's been very effective. Let's stay mobile on serve receive, because when we pass well, we're scoring.
Yeah. When they give Perez an opportunity to run his offense, he's been very, very effective, and that all starts with a really good pass from the Puerto Rican receivers.
And this is key. You see the badly handled serve receive, hand pass. I think if Puerto Rico continues to float tough balls short and long, they're going to continue to struggle on the Cuban side with their serve receive, because hand passing is not a strength.
That's right, and that ball was off the top of the block by number 14 Hernandez for Cuba, scoring the first point of the fourth set.
Despite a bad pass.
And a missed serve by Cuba. Scores 1-1 in the fourth set. Perez back to serve for Puerto Rico.
It's interesting how the crowd is beginning to grow here at the Norseca World
Qualifier. Hernandez with the pass. And strong attack out of the right side off the block by Cuba.
Yes, a great shot. Tooled off the outside arm. Wipe-off shot, as we call it, and good job from the right side. And I started to mention the crowd starting to thicken here as the match time between Canada and the U.S. draws closer.
Oh, a little miscommunication there.
Consequently, a free ball given up.
Another big attack up the middle for number 17, Jorge Gonzalez for Cuba. Gonzalez really has been quite effective with the middle attack when he's been given the opportunity to swing at the ball.
Yes, and I like what I'm seeing from Cuba right now. They're focused. We'll see if Esquerdo can keep distributing the ball well.
Quintana with a missed serve for Cuba.
And that's on a float serve. You know, that's the one you don't want to miss because you're not going for broke. I think if the float servers aren't serving well, then it is a bit hard for the spin servers to be as aggressive.
Right. Puerto Rico with the serve. Number two, Lopez. And mishandled by Cuba. Lopez scoring a direct point with the effectiveness of his serve.
Yes. Yeah, that's a youngster. Lazario on the floor. That's struggling there.
All right, let's see if he goes back to number 15, Treviso. Nope, it's handled by number 12, Gomez.
Not well. Yeah. Pass that ball to the target, but so fast that he didn't really have time to get out on approach. And they need a full approach to clear this disciplined Puerto Rican block.
We're seeing quite a few short serves by Puerto Rico right now. Is that likely a strategy that's being in play here, Brenda?
I think so. Particularly in this rotation, they're taking that left side player out. But in taking the left side player out, they really need to bunch in and help stop the middle a little bit more. It's one thing I noticed at this level, that because the teams haven't trained together that much, they're not doing a great job of bunch blocking and getting two or three up on everything.
That's Cuba with the serve. And another missed serve by Cuba. I think that's three early in this first set.
Yes, and the score is 5-4. I think three of the 5 points that Puerto Rico's earned are on Cuba's serves.
Number nine, Jose Ribas, back to serve for Puerto Rico. Serves down the line at number 15, Treviso.
Really tight set. Better.
Kept alive by Puerto Rico. And big block on number four, Arquila. Cuba gets an opportunity to throw up the triple block on that one, and they make Puerto Rico pay.
Yeah, that was a tight ball. A great block by Cuba. And we're all tied up at 5-5 in this fourth set. First three sets, Puerto Rico won 25-16. Cuba bounced back 25-22. Puerto Rico took the third, 25-18, to take them up 2-1, and that's where we are now.
And nice kill out of the middle by Puerto Rico.
Yeah, they're almost 100% on those fast sets in the middle.
Yeah, when he goes there, he doesn't use it often, but when Perez goes to his middle attackers, they're quite effective.
6-5 in the fourth.
Aggressive serve by Puerto Rico's number 12, Christian Rivera, goes just long.
Yes, that toss was behind his head, and he caught the bottom of the ball a little too much, reaching back for it.
And it's all tied up 6-6 with Cuba serving.
Conservative serve.
Nice back set, but big block by Cuba at the net on number 12, Christian Rivera, out of the backcourt.
Again, Lazaro Treviso, born in 1994, 16-year-old. Great block.
Cuba starting to show a little bit of dominance at the net with their blocking in the last few points. Serving again, number 17, Gonzalez. Arquila with the attack, handled by Treviso. And hit cross court off the top of the block for the point. That was number 15, Lazaro Treviso, who's coming alive here in this fourth set.
Got to be impressed with Treviso for being 16 years old. Unless this is a misprint in the program, that's a youngster on the floor, and he's playing like a man.
He's very, very young and playing with an awful lot of passion at this moment and being very effective with it. Well, we've got a two-point lead by Cuba. The score is 8-6, the first technical timeout. I think that timeout is very, very nicely timed for the Puerto Rican coaching staff, as I'm sure they wanted to talk to their players.
Ramon Lawrence spending extra time in the timeout talking with his setter, Xavier Perez, reminding him how effective the right side's been and the middle and to keep distributing the ball. Talking about rhythm a little bit too, I think. First man, second man.
Yeah, Puerto Rico has just been a little tentative in the last few rallies in their play, and I think they need to make sure that they continue to stay aggressive, because the aggressive play that they showed in the sets they've won has been the key to the victories.
Yeah, I'm not sure that Puerto Rico wants to run a naked high ball offense. They need to pass well. I think if it's a straight up naked high ball offense, Cuba has the edge.
And here we go, number 17 gone by Puerto Rico, kept alive by Cuba. Off speed shot out of the back court, really a broken play that goes long by number 12, Zami Gomez.
Yes, that's fundamental volleyball gone bad. You know, that bad pass, bad set, and then hit the ball out of bounds. They can do a lot better than that, I'm sure, and they're going to need to. So 1 point away from tying it up.
Healy with the serve. Gomez with the pass. Good pass out to number 15, Treviso. Rejected. To the back court. Big, big flying approach out of the back court by number 14, Yosvani Hernandez, but he gets blocked by a solid Puerto Rican block.
Yeah, Ramon Burgos. He's chalking up some big blocking numbers. He's their captain, and he's showing the coach, I meant to just touch it, but I put it down.
Arquila with the serve for Puerto Rico. Passed by Treviso, but poorly passed, and the Cuban setter is unable to handle that one.
Yes, Jorge Lopez did a great job of reading the setter and getting a good solid piece and pressing it back. Good block by Lopez.
Right, Puerto Rico to serve. Arquila. Handled by Treviso. A little roll shot by Treviso onto the block, kept alive. And a miss contact by number 14 out of the right side, Yosvani Hernandez.
Yeah.
Ball goes just long.
Izquierdo, the setter for Cuba, is losing his composure right now. He's really angry because there were two things that happened there. The Cubans thought that they got robbed on the call. No question Puerto Rico was on the net, at the top of the net, actually, and they didn't get the ball. So I think coach is spending his time saying, boys, don't get frustrated about what you don't control. Focus on putting the ball over the net, looking for holes. Hit the ball hard.
Yeah. Well, I mean, Brenda, we talked earlier in this match about the importance of controlling runs. At the technical timeout, Cuba was up 8-6, and now it's 10-8 for Puerto Rico. 4 points in a row for Puerto Rico, forcing the Cuban coach to call a timeout.
Yes, and two of those were on, as I said earlier, just fundamental breakdowns. Bad pass, bad set, hit out of bounds. Those are things Puerto Rico didn't do anything to earn. They're being given away, and those are the ones you got to stop as a coach.
Right.
Another bad hand pass.
Treviso with a sharp cross-court attack, but it's out of bounds. Cuba protesting, really feeling it hit a Puerto Rican defender. But Cuba argues, but referee won't budge.
Well, there's six sets of eyes on the game, and none of them saw a touch, so perhaps there wasn't one.
Arquila with the serve, and he misses just wide. You know, it's very interesting. Arquila is a very strong spin server, and he's been using a jump float serve for the majority of this match. I think that's a tactic that's in play, really feeling the Cubans don't handle the float serve very well.
Absolutely, and Canada capitalized on that last night as well.
And Arquila can't handle the Cuban serve.
Well,
passes the ball way to the left, and Javier Perez can't chase that one down.
And, you know, it may be that what we just said works both ways, because I don't think Puerto Rico manages a good float serve very well either, and there aren't a lot of them coming from Cuba. This is certainly one of them.
Izquierdo right back to Arquila, but he handles this one, although not that well. And another hit out of bounds by number 2, Lopez, for Puerto Rico.
This is so classic of this age group. We're riding a roller coaster. Both teams, up and down, up and down.
And the score is back tied at 11-11. Izquierdo went to serve. Passed by. Ball's kept alive. Outside to number 14, Yosvani Hernandez, who mishits that ball, and it's out of bounds.
The one thing I do have to question tactically, Doug, is why Cuba would even come close to serving at the Puerto Rican libero. He is good at serve-receive. No question he is good at serve-receive, and some of the others aren't. I'd be serving away from him. There's an interesting tight ball. Setter tried to use the block. Blocker pulled his hands out of the way, and the ball's out of bounds. So that's a Puerto Rican point. Credit to the server.
Ramon Burgos to serve for Puerto Rico.
Another tough float.
And ball in the middle to number five, Danger Quintana.
Gotta like that name, eh? Danger.
Danger. And he definitely showed he was dangerous on that play. Seemed to be a little bit slower tempo in the middle, but it was very effective for the Cubans. Cuba with the serve, very aggressive serve at Mulero, number 15, who handles that ball. And strong attack by Jorge Lopez.
And great job by Mulero. That's virtually a dig, not a serve receive, and he still put it inside the attack line. They're able to convert for a kill. So, you know, I think that rocketing jump serve at anybody else is probably translating into a point.
Puerto Rico with the serve. Serves to Treviso. Played with his hands. Set outside off the top of the block by number 12, Zami Gomez.
That was a really good job by Zami Gomez, hitting high. He only had one blocker on him, and you better score when your setter gets you one blocker, but did a very good job.
All right, number five, Quintana, back to serve for Cuba. Handled by Arquila. And a big solid kill by number two, Jorge Lopez, out of the right side for Puerto Rico.
Yeah, he earned that one fair and square. Straight down.
All right, Puerto Rico serving.
Another short hand pass.
Handled by Lopez. Attacked by number 14. Kept alive by Puerto Rico. Oh, and a little mistake there by number 12, Christian Rivero, trying to tip the ball over the block and doesn't even make the net with his tip.
Christian Rivera didn't really know where the ball was going to be. It was being forearm passed to him, and he didn't get an approach that was effective, tried to change it up, and just fell short.
Aggressive serve by number 14, Hernandez. Number 12, Gomez, kept alive by number 2. Oh, a miscue, overpass by Gomez to the Puerto Ricans, who put the ball away at the net.
Little catastrophizing going on. I'm not sure if that's a word in the dictionary or not, but it's certainly a word I like to use. When players start, oh my God-ing, with their hands on their head or lifting their uniforms over their faces, like, oh my goodness. You know, to me, that's catastrophizing behavior, and they're making a bigger deal out of things than they should. And as a coach, you got to get in their heads and calm them down and make them think ahead. They're down 2 points right now and 2-1. So if they don't bring it around right now, it's going to be over. But 16-14, it's still anybody's set.
It's really seeming right now that the Cubans are not comfortable playing a slower ball on defense. You know, they're overthinking that ball, and they're not playing it with confidence. And it's leading to a few little miscues that is also causing a lot of frustration among the members of the team.
Well, if I go back to the comment by the Cuban coach, from the very, very beginning, when Roberto Garcia said to me, a key for my team's success is concentration all match. Not just one set, not just two sets, but all match. And, you know, that speaks volumes, because here they are, you know, stringing some errors together that relate to lack of concentration.
Yeah, they've really been plagued by inconsistency through this match. We've seen some very good play out of Cuba and then some very poor play. Puerto Rico with the serve. After the timeout, the ball into the middle, kept alive by Puerto Rican defense. Oh, another great save by Puerto Rico. Out to Aquila, who really rips it cross court, but it's kept alive by Cuba. Oh, and then kind of a weak transition in the middle to number 3, Ramon Burgos, who just can't get it by the Cuban block.
Yeah, in fairness, that's tough. Yeah, I mean, it was set outside, set back, set middle, you know, distributing pretty evenly. I think it became predictable there. But Jorge Gonzalez did a fabulous job for Cuba, pressing that, committing to it, and sealing and pressing that ball to the floor.
Cuba with the serve. Pass by Mulero. Another great pass by the libero. Oh, and a big block by Cuba.
Yeah, that set was much too tight for Sammy Gomez, and he hit square into the middle blocker. And at this point, Jonathan Rivera Jorge Gonzalez is pumping his arms in the air, showing his pipes, and starting to feel confident. We're all tied up at 16-all.
Well, he was all over that tight set, and really let the Puerto Ricans know that he wants some momentum back for his side. Forced Puerto Rico to call a timeout.
Yes, and although I'm not in earshot of Roberto Garcia, I can tell very clearly that he is talking about the quality of your toss when you're serving. Slow down, give yourself a good toss, and let's get a good approach on our serve. Serving is key, boys. Serving is key.
Wow, we're into a very, very tight fourth set here, and a very important set. Puerto Rico trying to close this match out, and Cuba fighting for their survival as they are down one set to the Puerto Ricans.
And we'll see if they utilize the matchup between Ricardo Arquila, the left side blocker for Puerto Rico, and the right side attack for Cuba. It's been very good for Cuba in the past.
Strong serve by Cuba, long back set by Perez, kept alive by Cuba.
Yeah. At first I thought that was going to be let go, but that is extreme. And that's a double hit on the second contact.
Yep.
That same action on the first, of course, would not be called, but on the second contact, the libero mishandled the attempt to set and was shut down for it.
A little bit of a delay call on that, but Puerto Rico does end up with the ball, now serving. Well handled by Cuba. And that ball is hit. Quick attack up the middle by number 17, Jorge Gonzalez, but he just hits it out of bounds.
So that's two errors, 2 points in a row for Puerto Rico, one on a double hit volley and one on an attack out of bounds.
Puerto Rico now with a two-point lead, 18-16. And the serve goes just a little bit long, giving Cuba a little bit of a reprieve here from a couple unforced errors. And it's number 17, Jorge Gonzalez, back to serve.
And they got lucky. That was a one-inch too long serve, and I think a wing and a prayer there that it went out.
And right back with another missed serve by Gonzalez. It goes just long on the Puerto Rican side, giving Puerto Rico another two-point lead.
Doug, the one thing I really don't like right now, if I'm the Cuban coach, is how much they're transferring control of what's going on to the referee. They've got to focus on the things they control and stop being so worried about the calls. That's what they've got to do.
Big kill by Lazaro Treviso.
Hit the ball hard onto the floor, in the court, and then they don't need to worry about the referees.
Yep. All right, here we go. It's Izquierdo with the serve. Pass by Arquila. Ball in the middle. Quick attack by number 3, Ramon Burgos. That scores off a Cuban defender.
Scores 20-18 for the Puerto Ricans, and they're going to make a couple of substitutions. Into the game for Puerto Rico is Carlos Acosta. He's coming in to serve, and he replaces Ramon Burgos. And also coming out of the game is their setter, Xavier Perez, and he's being replaced by Emmanuel Romero, who's into block.
All right.
Acosta serving.
Puerto Rico making a sub, trying to create a little bit bigger lead in this match and close it out.
Acosta serve puts them in trouble.
Ah, big attack by number 15 for Cuba, Treviso, out of the right side. He's really now trying to take control of this match. He's kind of said, let me just get physical here and start putting the ball away.
Yes, Lazaro Treviso, a 16-year-old, pounded one home for Cuba. We're now at 19-20.
Treviso with the serve. And he hits it hard, but handled nicely by Arquila. Dumped by Perez, handled by Cuba. Outside attack. Great diving save by number 12, Christian Rivera, but he just can't quite handle it.
And we're all tied up at 20-20. We got ourselves a game, folks.
It's a very tight match.
Yeah, and it's at the hand of a 16-year-old here, Lazaro Treviso, on the service line. And we have a timeout. Puerto Rico wants to talk it over.
Coach Ramon Lawrence doesn't really like what he sees out there, and he's decided to call a timeout and bring his squad in for a little bit of a talk. Well, I don't know, but right now it seems to me that, you know, number 15, Lazo Treviso, is on fire for Cuba. And I think Cuba, the Cuban setter, needs to look for opportunity to get him the ball out of the backcourt.
Well, it's hard to say. He's a 16-year-old, so and he hasn't been a big factor out of the back row yet. I think the big thing right now is how he responds as a server, if he puts that ball in play, and whether Puerto Rico is able to handle the serve. So hopefully he's composed enough. I'm really struggling to believe he's 16. I know it's in our program here, but I look at the pipes, or the arms on that young man and think, 16? I don't know. He's been training for a while. And great serve.
Oh, another big, big serve. Kept alive by Arquila, but not more than that. Oh, and a beautiful, aggressive attack from a difficult position by Jorge Antonio Lopez for Puerto Rico.
Such animated frustration by the Cubans.
Javier Perez back to serve for Puerto Rico. 21-20 for Puerto Rico. Oh, and a bad mishandle by number 5, Quintana, for Cuba. Opportunity now for Puerto Rico. And they give it to Lopez. Oh, some great defense being shown. Arquila with the free ball pass. Back to Lopez. And Lopez puts it away this time. Wonderful attack in transition by Lopez for Puerto Rico. And we've now got a Cuban timeout.
Yes, they're down 20-22. And both teams are playing at 100%. Finally, we're seeing both teams swinging as hard as they can, getting their butts down on defense, transitioning quickly and well. This is what volleyball is meant to be at this level, and it's very exciting to see. I don't believe this set is decided by a two-point spread. I think this next point is going to be pivotal on getting Cuba back in or having Puerto Rico almost break away to be uncatchable.
Yeah, it should be very interesting. Of course, Brenda, as you know, the point immediately following a timeout is almost always a critical point for at least one of the teams, but often for both teams. And the winner of that point really often takes an advantage into the next couple plays.
I suspect we're going to see a jump float right into the breadbasket of the front row player in position 4. It's number 12 for Cuba at this point, and we'll see if Zami Gomez handles it well.
Here we go, Perez with a serve.
Oh,
nope,
he
goes the other
court.
Way to the youngster. Number 15, Treviso. He goes at the youngster, and the youngster can't handle the serve.
And yeah, I got to give credit to Coach Ramon Lawrence. I'm sure he called that ball moving away from the tactic that had been working for them. So now we'll see whether they go back at him or come short.
Treviso takes a big step up. I think he wants to play this one with his hands. No, he backs up and plays with his arms. Out to Gomez. Gomez, strong front course attack, but the Libo Molero keeps it alive. Oh, big, big block by Cuba. Big triple block. Set was a little bit tight, but they really put the roof on that one.
Danger, Quintana. You're not getting by me, buddy. And his reward is he's coming out now. Incoming is a serving specialist, Deron Arias. We haven't seen him yet, I don't believe, and I have no idea what kind of serve he's going to bring.
Oh, we'll see what he brings. 21-23, Cuba with the serve, Puerto Rico with the lead. Brings a solid one. Oh, passed a little tight by Arquila, can't be handled by Perez. But the call that is upsetting the Cuban players, Cuban blockers are being called for being over the net.
Yes, and again, giving up control to the referee. It is a controversial call. I'm not sure it's a wrong call, but it's controversial because it could have gone either way.
Lucky break for Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico with the serve, serving at 24-21, trying to close out this match. Pass by Gomez. Oh, and a nice solid kill by number 17, Jorge Gonzalez, in the middle. He's been very efficient with his middle attack so far in this match.
Yes, and gutsy by Escuerdo to set the middle at this must win. This is huge pressure on this server down 22-24. This is where you've got to put the ball in play, but you don't want to serve easy enough to allow Puerto Rico to do whatever they want.
Here he goes. Very aggressive serve. Outside to Arquila. And Arquila puts it away off the Cuban block. And Puerto Rico is just ecstatic. They are going to the World Championships next summer.
The Cubans can't believe it. They're all walking away from each other, feeling devastated. This is a big blow to the Cuban program. But great congratulations to Ramon Lawrence, his coaching staff, and the Puerto Rican Volleyball Federation. Huge win, decisive win, 25-22. They take this match 3-1, 25-16, 22-25, 25-18, and 25-22.
That's correct, yep. And I think it was a great, just a great, really steady performance by Puerto Rico. You know, they played a very steady match. You know, they had their ups and downs, but, you know, they did come back strong after every breakdown. Okay, we're now going to go down to the floor. Oh, apparently not.
Kim Vallier, are you there for us? No. Oh, they just need another moment on the floor.
I'm just waiting for my translator, and the coach, we're going to move over there because it's going to start the first game.
Okay. So we'll just be a moment for her. I do want to thank the Government of Canada, the Government of Quebec, the Ville de Gatineau, and SSN Sports for putting on today's broadcast and supporting this event. The Norseca 2010 Junior Men's Championships qualifiers, first, second, and third, go to the World Championships in Brazil next summer. And that will be Brazil, Canada, and the USA. The gold medal game will come to you in approximately 20 minutes. And we will see Canada and the U.S. playing for gold at the Norseca Championships 2010. Kim, are you there?
Yes, I am.
It's all yours, Kim.
Thank you. Coach, thank you. You're going to the Worlds. What are your impressions? What made the difference today?
Van a ir al Mundial. Denos sus impresiones. ¿Cuál fue la diferencia hoy?
Pienso que la diferencia que traímos hoy fue que los muchachos vinieron hoy enfocados en el juego que teníamos que hacer. Tuvimos hoy una reunión técnica donde se hablaron ciertas cosas desde el punto de vista técnico y táctico, y creo que se cumplió el objetivo que traíamos.
The team came today really focused on what they were supposed to do on the game. They were really fighting all the time. They were getting ready for all the points tactically. They were doing their job, and everything happened properly, so they were very happy with the result.
All right, thank you. I'll let you celebrate. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
I'll let you celebrate.
¿Cómo van a celebrar ahora?
No sé, creo que es algo que vinimos a buscar. Estamos contentos y ahora solo nos queda prepararnos para el Campeonato Mundial. Solo eso. Pero estamos muy contentos y los muchachos creo que han trabajado duro en este torneo.
Well, they don't really know. They're so happy. They came trying to find the qualification to World Championships. They're super happy. They really don't know how much they're going to celebrate. Now they're going to prepare for the World Championships and keep working hard.
Thank you. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Kim. Well, Brenda, it was quite an interesting match. Had its ups and downs. We saw some great performances, I think especially out of on the Puerto Rican side. The libero for Puerto Rico, Mulero, just had an outstanding match once again and really, really kept his side together throughout the match.
Yes, congratulations for sure to Puerto Rico. I'm sure they have a lot of work to do to be competitive at the Worlds, but they've hurdled the first step, which is getting there, and kudos to them. So that wraps things up here at the Norseca 2010 Junior Championships. We will be back in approximately 24 minutes for the gold medal game. We will be back on air in approximately 20 minutes as the teams prepare for the gold medal game, Canada versus the USA. This is SSN Sports, and thank you for listening.
Thanks.